you don't have safety gloves, you can grab a towel or something. You want to protect your hands from these knives. Also, you want to be holding the iPod up high from the top here. You don't want to be holding it like this, or you're going to be cutting yourself like that. Don't be holding it from the bottom down there. Hold it from the top up here like this. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go right about here where the first tab is. So let's see if we can get it in here. And there we go. Now once we've got it in there, we can actually remove the handle. There we go. That just helps us so we don't break the blade. And then the second one we're going to add is going to be right about the top of this center button there. So we're going to insert it right about here. Third one will be right in line with the play pause label there. Fourth one, right about here. We continue to work our way around the iPod. Just grab more blades from our supply. We'll go for the one up here, tab that's about slightly off center, right about here. Let's see, I'm gonna get a different blade, not that one. How about, see, this one might help. Oh, here's a good one. Okay, try to be out here. This may be a tough one. And there we go. Notice how it's popping up right there right now. So since it's popping up, these guys are actually going to be falling out like that. Switch blades here. Back to this one. Once again, we're going to go for the tab that's about halfway. Halfway down the screen, right about here. tab is right across, right about near the bottom of the screen, right there. Next tab is in line with about the top of the round button here. Last tab is in line with the pause play button label right there. Okay, right about here. You can see that the whole iPod is actually popping open now. There we go. We have two ribbon cables here. We have the hard drive here.